The celebration of the living stations of the cross. During this Holy Week, we have gathered together to accompany Jesus on his solemn journey to Calvary. This powerful event is an opportunity for our school community to come together to pray and reflect. You will be led through the 14 stations by the eighth graders, which commemorates Jesus' passion and death. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The first station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at the man standing. He is Pontius Pilate. He is the Roman governor and the most powerful man in Judea. Angry people have told lies about Jesus, and they want Pilate to kill him. Pilate knows Jesus is an innocent man. He knows he should not be killed. But Pilate is afraid. He wants the angry people to like him, to be his friends, or he might lose his job. So he tells them, "Go ahead and kill Jesus."
Step up close to Jesus. See how hard and fast he is breathing. He is afraid. He could stop these men if he wanted, because he is the Son of God. But then, who would make up for our sins? So Jesus is going to let it happen, because he loves us. He wants to save us and win heaven for us. Still, he's afraid. Put your hand in his. Let him know you care. Whisper to Jesus in our hearts, "Jesus, I'm here. I'll stay with you."
Dear Jesus, please make me brave so I can do what is right, even when it is hard to do. Don't let me be afraid to stand up for somebody when others are telling lies about that person. Help me to not put luxury, success, popularity, or my own opinions above what is right.
The second station, Jesus takes up his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at the quiet way. Jesus does what they tell him. He does not fight with the men who push him. He does not hate them and say rough words to them. If they had known he was dying for them, and for all of us, they would have acted differently. So Jesus forgives them. He thinks only of how he loves them and us. Then he takes up the cross, but in his heart, he asks his heavenly Father to help him carry it bravely.
Step up close to Jesus. See what a hard time he has getting the cross onto his shoulder. It is clumsy and heavy. His shoulders are already sore because they have whipped him extensively. There are thorns around his head too. Sometimes the cross hits these thorns. They go into Jesus' head like sharp nails. Whisper in our hearts, "Jesus, make me brave like you."
Dear Jesus, when something is hard for me to do, help me to remember how you took the cross without fussing about it. Help me to be good and kind to others, even when it is not easy. Help me to control the anger in my life. Help me to take responsibility for both the good and the bad things that happened to me.
The third station, Jesus falls for the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at how Jesus is stumbling along, struggling just to stand. The cross is crushing his shoulder, and the sharp stones in the road cut his bare feet. All around him, people are shouting and pushing, and Roman soldiers who have been ordered to crucify him want him to hurry. Jesus tries as hard as he can to move faster, but he stumbles and falls.
Step up close to Jesus. See him trying to get up. He wants to keep carrying his cross. Everybody around him is yelling and poking at him. But Jesus does not get angry. He offers all the hurting to his heavenly Father for us because he loves us. Then he pulls himself to his feet and walks forward. Think that you put your arms around him. Whisper in our hearts, Jesus, teach me to be loving like you.
Dear Jesus, if something hurts me today, remind me to offer my hurt to God. Do not let me be mean to anybody who gets hurt or who makes mistakes or to anyone who is different from me. Help me to love others as you loved us.
The fourth station, Jesus meets his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at that lady, reaching out to Jesus from the crowd. She is his mother, Mary. She comes close, and her face is full of tears. Tears are on Jesus' cheeks, too. You can tell how much they love each other. Look at Jesus and see a son who honors and respects his mother out of the great love he has for her. Jesus performed his first miracle because his mother expressed concern for the shortage of wine at a wedding. Although this man is the Son of God and needs nothing, he still follows the Father's command to honor his mother. But Mary is not allowed to stay close to Jesus, to say kind and loving words to him. They make her go away.
Step up close to Jesus. He feels so sad to have his mother see him all bruised and beaten. He knows it makes her unhappy, but she is brave like him. She knows that he chose to carry the cross, and if that's what God planned for Jesus, she wants Jesus to do it. They are both willing to do what God wants them to do, because what God wants is always good for us. Whisper in our hearts, help me to always do what is good.
Dear Jesus, when I have to be away from someone I love, help me to offer my lonely feelings to you. Help me to do what God wants me to do today. Help me to always respect those in authority. Help me to always do what is good and just.
The fifth station. Simon helps Jesus carry his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at that man helping Jesus carry the cross. This is Simon of Cyrene. He was on a pilgrimage to Jerusalem for the Passover feast when he was stopped and told to help carry Jesus' cross. At first, Simon did not like having to help Jesus. He thinks, "Why must I help this man? Who is he that the crowd so hates him? He has these doubts and questions because Simon did not know Jesus. But later, when he found out who Jesus was, he was proud that he had helped to carry the cross.
Step up close to Jesus. See how Simon is trying to get hold of the cross and carry it for Jesus. Simon is strong, but the cross is heavy, yet not too heavy. Jesus never asks us to do something we cannot do. Sometimes, when you have hard things to do, it is Jesus asking you to carry the cross as he asked Simon. Try to think then. Jesus is making you strong. Whisper in our hearts, Jesus, I want to be proud like Simon that I helped you with your cross.
Dear Jesus, make me strong when I have to do something hard. When I don't like to do something, do not let me push it off on somebody else. I don't really want to be singled out, but one look at Simon shows me the importance of helping my brothers and sisters. Help me to willingly and joyfully help others.
The sixth station. Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at that woman standing before Jesus. We call her Veronica, a poor Jewish woman who sees love in this man's face. She has pushed her way through the crowd to get to Jesus. That was a brave thing to do, with all those rough people around to scare her. She does not understand how they can look at his kind, loving face and do these terrible things to him. But she does not think of them. She thinks only of how she wants to give Jesus a handkerchief to wipe his face. When Jesus gives it back to her, there is an image of his face on the handkerchief. It was Jesus's way of thanking her.
Step up close to Jesus. Think how, if men can be proud because Simon helped Jesus, females can be proud because Veronica helped Jesus too. It does not matter who we are. What is important to God is what is in our hearts. If our hearts are good and kind, that is the best and most important thing. Whisper in our hearts, Jesus, print your face on my mind and my heart so I can learn to be more and more like you.
Dear Jesus, let me be thankful to people who help me when I need help. Help me do kind things for other people, even if I don't get any reward. Jesus, you based your words and actions on charity and the greater good of others. Help me to be gracious and generous.
Seventh station, Jesus falls the second time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at how hard it is for Jesus to walk. He feels weak and shaky. He has had nothing to eat or drink, and he hurts all over. But the soldiers won't let him stop and rest. They keep pushing at him to walk faster. He tries, but again he falls down in the dirty street, and the heavy wooden cross falls on top of him.
Step up close to Jesus. Stoop down to where he has fallen in the street. He is out of breath and very tired. It would help if he could just lie there a minute, but he gets up and tries walking again. You were not there when all this happened, but remember, what you do or say to Jesus now counts as if you had been there. Whisper in our hearts, Jesus, thank you for showing me how to always get up and to keep going.
Dear Jesus, when I try to do something and mess it up, help me to start over again as you did. If somebody falls down or gets hurt, let me feel for them and help them if I can.
The eighth station, Jesus meets the weeping women. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at the women of Jerusalem who are standing at the corner of the street where Jesus is passing. When Jesus draws near, they fall to their knees, sobbing and weeping for him. They feel sorry for him and say loving words to him. They are weeping because they have been touched by the immense love and compassion of Jesus. Jesus has never given them worldly goods, but he offered his love, his mercy, his hope, and now his life. He tenderly reaches out to them. Even now in his pain, he doesn't think of himself, but stops to comfort them. He tells them that he will feel better if he knows that they will always be kind and gentle toward everyone for the love of him. And if they teach their children to do the same, they are good women. They will do what Jesus asks.
Step up close to Jesus. Listen when he talks to these women. It is hard to behave well when you are sick or feeling bad. It takes much courage to be unselfish like that. But Jesus does not think of himself. He thinks only of being kind to these ladies. Whisper in our hearts, Jesus, help me to be thoughtful of others as you are.
Dear Jesus, show me how I can help others and make them happy. Teach me to share what I have with others and to not always try to keep the best of everything just for myself. Help me to think beyond my possessions and to think about things that bring joy to others.
The ninth station, Jesus falls the third time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at Jesus now. He is walking slower and slower. He's been nearly beaten to death and has fallen twice already. The soldiers wish he would hurry. They are afraid that all the excited people watching Jesus and yelling at him may cause a riot. Jesus is packed in so close he can hardly breathe. He takes several more steps and then falls down in the dirty street for the third time.
Step up close to Jesus. He is flat on the ground. It is very hard for Jesus to move, but he gets to his knees and pushes himself up again. He knows he has to go on. Jesus does not like all this pain. He would like to be rid of it, but he can't stop now if he wants to do what will help us, and he wants to. He started this way of the cross for God and for us, and he wants to finish it. Whisper to him in our hearts, Jesus, you are a hero.
Dear Jesus, if I am slow and people rush me, help me not to get upset. Help me to be kind to everybody, because every one of us needs help sometimes. When I fail, please give me the strength and the courage to keep picking myself up and continuing. Help me to keep going when times are tough and it would be easier to quit than to continue.
The 10th station, Jesus' clothes are taken away. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at Jesus. He's outside the city of Jerusalem now and standing on a hill called Calvary. The soldiers are going to crucify him here. One of them is pulling off Jesus' clothes. The clothes are sticking to Jesus' sore back. It hurts when they are pulled off, just as it hurts when somebody pulls a band-aid off a sore on your knee. This mass, a thief, is being crucified alongside of Jesus. He realizes his sins and asks Jesus to forgive him, to remember him when he comes into his kingdom. Jesus promises this mass that he will join him today in paradise.
Step up close to Jesus. He stands there without his clothes. He's like a wrestler or boxer who takes off his ordinary clothes so he can fight better. Jesus is getting ready for a fight also. He is fighting against death and sin. He wants to win the fight. He wants to make it possible for all of us to have a life that lasts forever in heaven. We are on Jesus' side and want him to win. Whisper to him in our hearts, Jesus, I am cheering for you.
Dear Jesus, keep me strong in the battles I'll have to fight to be good and true to you. Let me never forget that I can pray for your help when I am at Mass. Help me to share the gifts God has given me with those who need them.
The 11th station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at Jesus. He has been laid flat down on the cross. One soldier takes spikes and hammers them through Jesus' hands. After, Jesus' feet also are nailed. The soldiers fixed the cross into a hole so it would stand straight. Everyone stands around and looks at Jesus. The good people feel unhappy because they love Jesus. The people who don't love him are unhappy too because they have done something bad. It was a very sad day, that first Good Friday.
Step up close to Jesus. He hurts all over. His head aches. He is thirsty, but in his heart, he is not sad like the people. He knows that what he chose to do was the right thing. Now he looks down at the men who nailed him to the cross, and he forgives them. Then he tells Mary to be a mother to all of us and to count us as her children. He keeps thinking of others, even when he is dying. Whisper to him in our hearts, Jesus, I love you.
Dear Jesus, when somebody hurts me, help me to be forgiving, and help me to live so Mary will be proud to count me as her child.
The 12th station. Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at Jesus, hanging on the cross. He has been there for 3 hours. He hurts all over. He is so thirsty, but nobody brings him any water. Jesus does not complain. He prays to his heavenly Father and tells him that he has finished what had to be done. He bows his head and dies. A soldier runs a spear into Jesus' side. Blood and water come out, a sign that Jesus gave everything. Many will wish that they would have met him sooner, so that they could have lived their lives according to his way. You still have that chance.
Step up close to Jesus. He is dead on the cross. He suffered all this because he wanted to put down death and find a way to give life. He has met death and won the fight with it, but it does not look that way. He hangs there, so still, as if death has him for good, but it doesn't. Jesus once said he was life. He told everybody that if they would wait 3 days after his death, he would show them that life had won the fight over death. Whisper to him in our hearts, Jesus, I believe you bring life.
Dear Jesus, no matter where I am, how long I live, or what happens to me, let me always be thankful that you died for me. At the hour of your death, I will look at you and see love, hope, and mercy.
The 13th station. Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at Jesus. After his body has been taken down from the cross, and the blood and dirt washed away, the sharp thorns have been taken off too. Now he is lying on his mother's lap. She holds him lovingly. She keeps saying his name over and over, how she loves him. Her heart is broken, but she does not cry or give up. She remembers about waiting 3 days.
Step up close to Jesus. All his enemies are gone now, so those who love him can come near and stay with his mother. If you had been there, you would have done the same. And you would have been proud of Mary's being so brave. You would not have cried either, even though your heart would hurt for Jesus. You would be thinking about the third day. Whisper to him in our hearts, Jesus, I love you.
Dear Jesus, when somebody dies, help me to remember that you have given new life and that I can see that person in heaven. Let me be kind and helpful if someone in my family is sad.
The 14th station. Jesus is put in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Look at how Jesus' friends have put clean clothes on his body and sprinkled him with a sweet-smelling perfume. Now they are putting his body into a tomb. The tomb is a small cave-like room cut out of a big rock. After they lay him inside, they leave the tomb and roll a giant stone in front of the doorway. It is so large that it takes several big men to roll it into place. Then they all go home.
Step up close to Jesus. You cannot see Jesus because he is still inside the tomb. It is Saturday, the next day. Pontius Pilate, the judge who let Jesus be killed, sent soldiers to the tomb so that nobody would steal the body of Jesus. The soldiers sit by the tomb all day and all night. Imagine that you also sit there and that you watch, pray, and remember the promise of the third day. Whisper to him in our hearts, Jesus, I am waiting for you.
Dear Jesus, help me to pray even when I cannot see you or you don't seem very near to me. Teach me how to wait when I cannot have what I want right away. Help me to be patient and allow your ways to happen as you have them planned.
He chose to walk down. angels.